Welcome to my Love Engineering channel. In today's topic, I'm going to teach you with a new topic called electrical machines. The second part is the static machine. In electrical machines, the category I said you are rotating machine or non-rotating machine. In the previous lecture, I taught you what is a rotating machine. I gave a beautiful example as universal motor. In this lecture, I'm going to show you what is a static machine. What is a static machine? The static machine is going to be a kept stationary, but there is an energy transfer takes place from one circuit to other circuit. The beautiful example I'm shown here is a transformer. Let us consider an example. This is an adapter which I took from our household appliance. This is an adapter. This is an AC charger. I removed the AC charger. I took a transformer because the AC charger, the input is 230 volt. The output is 12 volt. So it is a transformer because it is reducing the voltage from higher voltage to the lower voltage. Actually, watch the transformer does. It is going to transfer the energy from one circuit to other circuit. See, this is one circuit. See, this is a circuit in the sense this is the primary winding and this is a secondary winding. So from the primary, if the 230 volt is given, from the secondary, I'm taking only 12. What actually happens here? So energy transfer takes place. Okay, now in this lecture, I will teach you what are the construction of a transformer. What are the components actually present in a transformer? So three major components are, one is a core, one is a primary winding, and another is called a secondary winding. What is a core? Core is a laminated, because always in electrical machines, all the materials are made up of silicon steel for lamination in order to reduce hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. This content of losses will be explained in the future lectures with a clear explanation of what is a transformer, what is a classification of transformer, how it is working. So in this video, I'm going to show you what are the components actually present in a transformer. So this is a winding. You see this winding, I'm segregating this winding. So this is a black wire denotes it is a secondary winding. This red wire denotes it's a primary winding. So this is a shell type transformer. Shell type in the sense that we can connect the either your core will be surrounded by the winding or winding will be surrounded by the core. Based on the application, whether you are going for high power rating or low power rating, we will define the transformer construction in terms of core type, shell type and berry type. This is a shell type transformer because your core is surrounded by, because your core is surrounding the windings. How is that? Now you see, this is a primary, this is secondary part and this is a primary part. How I am going to connect my core? This is an e-clamping, this is an e-clamping, this is i-clamping, this is, they will say this point is a limb. Limb is a connection part. I'm just connecting the transformer. See, I'm connecting the transformer with this core. Now you have, once it is inserted in the one direction, you have to take in the opposite direction. Now you see, I'm taking this i-clamp, I'm fixing here. Simultaneously, n number of e-clamps and i-clamps should be connected. They will be stacked together. Stacked in the sense, it should be tight. There should not be any gap in between this core. The purpose of lamination is in order to reduce your eddy current loss and hysteresis losses. So from in this video, I think definitely you have understand what are the components actually present inside the transformer. The three components, one is a core. The core is a laminated. It is made up of silicon steel. The purpose of silicon steel lamination in order to reduce your hysteresis and eddy current loss. And the one more is the primary winding. What is a primary winding? Wherever you are giving a supply, which part you are giving a supply, that part is called a primary winding. You see, the thickness of wire is more. So this is a supply. Here it is a 230 volt. Now you see, this is a secondary winding. Secondary winding means where I'm connecting my load. So here it is a 230 volt, here it is 12 volt. That is, the energy is stepping down, that is, the voltage is get reduced. So it is a transformer. If you have any doubts, you comment me in comment box, like my channel, share my channel, subscribe. To get the notification of continuous videos of my channel, press the bell icon. Thank you.